101.1 WJRR, Orlando's Rock Station, Lynch and Taco Show. Time to tech it out with some technology news brought to you this morning by Trippin' Thursday on the JRR Instagram at 101.1 WJRR.
Where are you tripping to this week? Well, if you win, you could be going to the Moxie South Beach. A vacation down in Miami. How about that? If you're not following us on Instagram, it is at 101.1. WJRR at 101.1 WJRR. We explain what to do on the post-storm.
Let's begin this week's Tech It Out with the latest use of technology. Well, in this case, to blow up terror groups. It's thought that it's Israel who is behind the last 2 days of, well, very... this had to take a lot of planning and execution and just to pull this all off. Where they managed to take out some Hezbollah terrorists 2 days ago by blowing up all of their pagers simultaneously.
Mm-hmm.
Then yesterday, they blew up their walkie-talkies.
Who do we get a lot of stuff from?
What do you mean?
Who do we as a country get a lot of stuff from?
China.
Think what I'm getting at. Could you imagine... Right here, what I'm holding up.
Well, that was originally...
I know that was originally the thing. I was holding up my cell phone, by the way.
The irony in all of this is the Hezbollah members shed cell phones and smartphones so they could not be tracked by the Israelis who are trying to hunt them down and end their terror network.
Mm-hmm.
And we here at the Lynch and Taco Show applaud them for that.
Well done.
If you feel differently, there's a college campus you can go to and... cry there.
And throw bricks at something. Anyway, there's a whole pile of bricks already set up for you.
The irony is they shed their current technology for older technology.
And then that was rigged to blow up.
We're able to.
But I was thinking, dude, if China was to do, with our cell phones.
Don't even put that out there in the...
Like it's not already thought of after all this Hezbollah crap.
So, Americans, Hezbollah and Hamas, both, anyway. Americans can now renew their passports online and bypass the paper applications. Now, in Florida, we were lucky here because we were one of the states in the pilot testing program where adult passport holders who had expired passports within the past 5 years could just simply renew them online. I did that last year. Super easy and simple. Now they were happy with the results. They're rolling this out nationwide where, if you're in that group I just described, an adult passport holder that had yours expire within the last 5 years or will expire in the coming year, you can do this online. Not available for the renewal of children's passports or for first-time passport applicants.
Yeah, makes sense.
So just be aware of that. If your passport's about to expire or whatever, you don't have to go through the whole tiresome paperwork process. You can do it online.
And to make you aware of something, I never knew this, and I've been a passport holder for years now. If you're going out of the country and you only have 6 months left on your passport, there's certain countries that you're not going to be able to get into because of that. Or you won't be able to get out of.
Renew them now.
Yeah. Check your passport and renew it ahead in case some trip falls in your lap.
Meta is rolling out teen accounts on Instagram. Teen accounts coming to Instagram. Parent company Meta Platforms is rolling out the new option with built-in protections. Parents can limit who can contact their teenage children and set a timer on their screen time. The feature is for both new and existing accounts. Current teenage users will be notified that their profiles will be migrated over to the teen tier.
I heard this and I saw it and I'm not usually a skeptic on things. I'm like, how are you really going to monitor? I'm 21, you know?
Well, this is putting the parents in the loop as well, so.
Any kind of, get the parents involved is good, just.
Google is working on satellite technology that will improve the detection of wildfires. The search giant is investing in an artificial intelligence-powered enhancement to its camera network in space, allowing users to see fire activity on Google Maps. The company is spending $13 million to improve current satellite imaging to pick up flames in an area as small as 16 square feet. The upgraded system is expected to be ready as soon as next year. Amazon announcing their October Prime Day dates. Put them in October to get you geared up for the start of shopping season and Black Friday in November, I guess, Taco.
Hey, speaking of...
It'll be October. It'll start on Tuesday, October 8th, and run for 2 days.
Speaking of ordering stuff, you know, for the holidays, and it's crazy that we're already talking about that stuff. Are they getting any closer to figuring out this cargo picketing or whatever? Not picketing, but the cargo strike, the cargo ship strike. No.
What cargo ship strike?
Google it.
Dish and DirecTV are in merger talks again. These two companies have talked about this on and off over the years. And the last time they came close to doing it, federal regulators said no, that would be a direct threat to competition. However, the landscape has changed tremendously in TV delivery services now, where they're thinking that this might actually gain approval, as both Dish and DirecTV are shedding customers like a dog sheds hair.
Yeah. I told you, I think a couple weeks ago, even my parents in their 80s went to YouTube TV.
Now, don't get me wrong, the satellite companies, they still serve a there's large areas of this country where internet service isn't all that great.
Yeah,
so you know, still having the ability to use a dish on your home or business,
that's good,
is useful. So maybe those two combining forces probably at this point makes more sense than not.
Mm-hmm.
And oh boy, here we go with technology. NFC manicures are the latest nail trend. Near-field communication. Yes, you can have ultra-tiny tech chips done on your manicures, ladies. So you can, you know, tap your phone and open your TikTok or Instagram now, or have someone pick up a picture on their phone off of something you embed in the chip on your nail.
Or, I don't know, somebody grab you and force your finger to open your bank account. On your phone.
I don't think your bank accounts are going to be linked to your manicures, but hey, you never know these days.
That's how you pay for it.
That's your technology, and tech it out for this week.
Thank you, sir.
Lynch and Taco's commercial-free workday rock block is coming up. Will there be a double dose of Metallica in there somewhere that will trigger a ticket giveaway for their shows in Tampa we announced this morning? Yeah. June 6th and 8th, Raymond James Stadium.
We shall see.
At some point, we'll play a double dose of Metallica once the second of the two songs start. We'll take caller 72 for tickets, and it'll play sometime before we get off the air at 10 o'clock. Caller 72, of course, in honor of the M72 World Tour. Newly announced dates here in Florida.
Lynch and Taco on the...